Battle of Gettysburg, the Confederate troops have won nearly everywhere, but they haven't yet been able to take the Union positions on the high ground behind the town, and that proves to be a critical difference. The delay in taking those Union positions allows the Army of the Potomac to fortify itself, and General Meade, who arrives after midnight on that first night, it allows him a chance to fortify his fishhook and extend the Union lines in a way that secures them a defensive position that will prove to be important and essential for their ultimate victory in this battle. One of the striking things about the first day's battle at Gettysburg is that neither commander of the armies was there. They were both rushing to the scene along with many other divisions and brigades in their armies, but they weren't here until late in the afternoon of the first day in Lee's case and late into the night of the first day in General Meade's case, the Union commander. And so while we're here in front of a monument devoted to General Lee, built by the state of Virginia, I think it's worth taking a minute to talk about the two commanders. Robert E. Lee was, even at the outset of the Civil War, a kind of legend in the Federal Army. He had been a hero in the Mexican-American War. He was the son of a Revolutionary War hero. He was widely respected, the former commandant at West Point. He was offered command of the Union Army at the outset of the conflict, but he refused to take up arms against his home state. He left